Hi everyone, welcome. This week we are going to discuss about the chapter 10, the imports and growth of the multinational company. So here we're going to talk about the imports and growth of MNC, simply known as MNC, multinational companies, and understand the benefits of being a multinational company, right, to a business organization, understand the benefits to a country from an MNC, and understand the possible drawbacks to a country or economy from MNC. So we are talking about mainly is a really, really important lesson for all of us, because MNC is a normally, you know, business type of, I think a lot of people, I think these days, I think they're familiar with the MNCs mainly because there are large MNC multinational companies are there, because we talk about the individual level sole traders and then private limited company, then public limited company, then only you can actually think about by expanding into other countries, you can become a multinational country, multinational company. So here, multinational company definition, you can see a business organization, a limited liability company, which is operating more than one country and having the manufacturing and assembly plant in more than two countries. You can see like mainly multinational means if you have to mainly participation in the business operations more than one country. Right. So you can see here the world. If you talk about, first of all, before I actually go into definition and the features and characteristics, so let's see what are the biggest multinational companies in the world. According to Wikipedia, you can see the biggest list of largest companies by revenue. You can see here Walmart. You can see American multinational company Walmart retail chain. There are 2.3 million employees. So you can see like they have annual turnover revenue wise, you can see 559 million US, which is billion, right? So 59, a profit of 13, can see 13,600. And can see, let's say State Grid electricity company in China, and Amazon, the third biggest company from retail information technology, so their revenue wise, United States, China Petroleum, Sinopec Group, that's oil and gas, Apple Electronics, the sixth biggest company in the world, CVS Health, United States, United Health Healthcare, Toyota, ninth biggest company automotive, and Volkswagen automotive, Berkshire Hathaway, 11th one, and also Maxens Healthcare Group, and you can see like that is the biggest company. So all these things you can see world's biggest 10 multinational companies, 10 biggest multinational companies are, these are the things according to the this website, senat.me website. You can see Exxon Mobil, you can see 2016, like sometimes it's not up to date, but here they have given the all, you know, gas from Microsoft, Citigroup, Bank of America, British Petroleum, China, and also that position moment mainly. These are the biggest, you know, multinational companies in the world. As a multinational company, you can see like Apple, no? They say according to the 66,000 employees, 41 years old company, and then Alphabet, now you can see headquarters United States, 69,000 employees. Alphabet is the, you know, the sub famous one owned by the Google. You can see Alphabet founded in 2015. People who started the Google, you know, the Sergey Brin, and all Microsoft, Berkshire Hathaway, the this one Berkshire Hathaway company owned by Oracle of Omaha, you know, the investment guru, the billionaire, right? These are the all famous billionaires. You can see in the Forbes magazine, all these people own multinational companies, famous multinational companies. Right now you can see the richest persons in the world, Jeff Bezos and Tesla. You can see owners, you can see these are the huge multinational companies. You can see Amazon owner, right? This son Jeff Bezos, multinational company operations everywhere, right? Elon Musk, Tesla, Bernard Arnold, Louis Vuitton and fashion retail branch, Bill Gates, Microsoft, multinational company, Facebook, multinational company, everywhere, right? And Warren Buffett, the Berkshire Hathaway investment company, Larry Ellison, software company, Google, Larry Page, Sergey Brin. So these all companies are multinational company. You can see when Mukesh Ambani, Diversified Group, he's the 10th richest person in the world right now, right? And then Amancio Ortega, Sara, multinational company, L'Oreal, France, and, you know, perfumes industry, China, beverage industry, and also Microsoft, United States, Steve Ballmer. So many. So all these biggest companies in the world, you can see all the biggest, the richest people in the world, they own multinational companies because their business territory is their world, right? So they're actually not limited to one state or one country. Their business operating in more than one countries, right? So multinational corporations, you can see the getting started thing in the last 40 years. So some business may have developed large operations in many different countries. They serve global markets and provide jobs and other benefits to the countries which may locate. They call multinationals. Look at the example below. Let's do this case study, LG Electronic. LG, one of the largest business corporations in South Korea, LG Electronics. In 2016, it had 125 operations and employed 77,000 people, right? So they got their participation, 125 countries, 77,000 people. So LG's product range is grouped into four divisions: home entertainment, mobile communication, vehicle components, home appliance, and AR solutions. Right? Like that, their business organization is based on four different criteria: home entertainment, mobile communication, right, including smartphone, tablets, and vehicle components, including infotainment system, electronic safety systems, and other electronic components, home appliances, including washing machine, microwave, cooker, vacuum cleaner. You know, LG is a very famous brand, South Korean brand. And look at their revenue, sales figures, you can find from 2012 to 2016. So their sales figures goes like that, steadily goes up, and then even 2015, 16, it will go on down. But look at the values in billions, right? So this is sales revenue in billions. You can see the huge amount of money. So what we can get some idea of these companies, you can see asking some particular four questions. LG enjoys huge global revenue. Figure 10.1 shows the revenue generated by company between 2012 and 2015, right? So LG, you can see their revenue and everything. You can see what evidence is there to suggest that LG is a multinational company. Now we're looking at this information, the contextual, you can see LG operate 125 locations. That's one aspect, because multinational, we normally we define a business organization who operates more than two countries, you can see. And why are multinational important for the global economy? Why this kind of businesses are important? And suggest one possible reason why a company might become multinational, why they wanted to go to multinational without operating in one country. In groups, right? We'll see the business actually, what are the possible answer for this question? Some showing example answer for this. You can see what evidence is there to suggest that LG is a multinational company. Right, okay. Multinationals are huge business organizations with production operation in at least two different countries. This is the definition. Multinational companies are huge business organization with production operation in at least two different countries. Right, so there is minimum must be two, maximum there is unlimited, right? You can go up to the world country. You can see about, we have about 195 countries, and then you can see then the world. You can see some countries, some businesses are there operating entire everywhere, right? Now 125 countries mean naturally it's a big amount. LG Electronics, 2016, it had 125 global operations and employed 77,000 people worldwide, right? And enjoy massive revenue. For example, in 2016, LG generated $55,367 million in sales revenue. Right. Second question they're asking, why are multinationals important for global economy? Why MNCs are important, right? Can't we actually support our own business, local business, infant businesses are there? Can't we manufacture our own? Yes, we can. But you know, multinationals are also important because their technology, their financial superiority, their marketing superiority, and sometimes economies of scale. Multinationals, that's the main reason I'm looking for that. Normally, multinationals are important for the global economy because of the contribution they make to global output and employment. Huge corporations like LG Electronics employ lots of people worldwide, and this gives people income and improves their living standards. So multinationals also pay taxes, which the host government can spend on public services, such as water, provision, and education. Most multinationals also produce a wide variety of products that provide consumers with lots of choice and helps to improve the quality of life. That's why they're giving some advantage of multinational companies. They're providing some, improve the income and the living standards of the people. And also they pay taxes to the government. So tax income of the government also increasing the fiscal, you know, that then government can actually pay that Like government tax revenue can be used to something welfare of the economy, to maintain of the important essential services. So that was another important thing. And like some water provision and education, some examples. And most multinationals also produce a wide variety of products that provide consumers with a lot of choice and helps to improve the quality of life. Yeah, because local business, sometimes they are unable to go to that capacity. But multinationals are providing their mechanism, their machines, their technology, right? Their research and development. They can provide a wide variety of products which helps people to improve their quality of life. Example, in this case, LG. You can see LG, how many, you know, televisions, how many washing machines, how many technological products they have actually improved. Yeah, that because of that, how much actually our activities become so convenient. Yeah? From mobile phone, tablets also, and also television, communication-wise, and also mobile, you know, vehicle, the accessories, so many things. So we can see it mainly enhance our quality of life. And as a result, the quality of life will increase, living standard will increase. Right. Question number three asking, suggest one possible reason why a company might become a multinational. Right. If you want to become a multinational company, you should start to expansion purpose. I think that this can be happening on the long run, because the initial first survival stage, business cannot actually operate in other countries because they need more capital. I think in the long run, you can expand your business into other countries, in other regions, and you can become a multinational country, right? Sometimes you might have already a business operations in more than two countries. So that means you can, namely, you can say, okay, I also have a small multinational companies, right? Group of company, multinational, we have operations in more than companies. I know some companies are there, export companies, exporting companies, they are exporting some spices and everything. Right, they have right branches manufacturing in happening in Cambodia, sometimes in Indonesia, sometimes they have a selling locations in Germany, selling location in America, USA, like that. So manufacturing locations and selling location, either it can be manufacturing locations or selling locations. They have some business arms in more than two countries, right? Multinational, that's why. One of the main reasons why business become multinational is because such business organizations, such large business can lower, they can cost, right? The large organization can lower their costs. You can see LG Electronics. In this case, the cost and exploiting economies of scale. The economies of scale mean like you can purchase like in a large bulk items, and you can have some discounts, and also marketing economies of scale, purchasing economies of scale, risk bearing economies of scale, right? Technical economies of scale. There are so many economies of scale. So the economies of scale, when the business expands, the average cost can fall. That's the thing. When the business expand, average cost can go down. That topic we are going to separately discuss in another session called economies of scale under production management. So that's why multinational companies have that power. The cost can go down because of the large operations that are happening, expert economies of scale. This means they can make more profit, and this will benefit the shareholders as they are likely to receive higher dividends, higher dividend, right? Let's move on to the multinational company, right? Mainly importance and growth. So you can see the importance of growth of multinationals. The multinational, the contribute about 10% of the world GDP, right? According to that, you can see the world contributed multinational, the contribution about 10% of the world GDP. GDP stands for gross domestic production. So world output, 10% comes from the multinational. And about 66% of the global export. They have significant and increasing role in the world economy. The number of multinationals in the world has increased from about 7,000 in 2070 to about 78,000 in 2005. Right, that's the growth of the multinational companies in the world, 7,000 in 1970s and now 78,000 in 2005. Right, and between them, they employ over 70 million workers and around 3% of the global workforce, about 3% of the global workforce. The role played by the multinationals in the global economy is likely to remain important well into the future. Table 10.1 provides a summary of the information about the world's five largest multinationals at the end of 2015, right? Like I see, this must be updated, but you know, now in 2015 level is Walmart, State Grid, China, the electrical one, and also China National Petroleum, Sinopec Group, Royal Dutch Shell UK. This is the main biggest five, big five. But here, according to Wikipedia, you can see this is the sometimes at least you can see this this color. Highlighted one is a state-owned enterprises, government-owned more than 50% or more. According to that, the private largest private business retail one is a Walmart in the United States. Walmart, you know, supermarket chain in the world. Walmart chain, and then they have you can see the employees 2.3 million, 2.3 million employees only supermarket chain globalized business. And also if you search about the Walmart, about the business organization, you can find out more. State grid is a China organization. They are provide electricity to the nation, 50 more than 50% owned by the government. And Amazon information, you know, world's now biggest retailer in the world. And these two also another China government organization, China Sinopec Group, and also China National Petroleum, and number four and five. And you go to Apple and CVSL. So look at the first one, Walmart. Right, Walmart business. You can see this is Walmart, the current logo. And then this formality, you can see Walmart, it's a discount city, and then type it's a public traded in New York Stock Exchange. Walmart, and then retail industry founded in 1962. So it's 51 years old, right? 59 years old ago in Arkansas. And also founded is Sam Walton. Sam Walton, the founder, we call Uncle Sam sometimes, nickname. He's a founder of the supermarket chain, right? Before that, there was actually the greatest history in the world. Actually, supermarket chain were not that much popular. But Sam Walton, he pioneered that thing actually in USA. The people can self-service, and they can have some shopping cart, and they can come inside to the shop, and they can buy anything they want. So at the end of the counter, there's a cashier who actually can pay, and you can go to your car. That system was introduced by this Sam Walton. There's a convenience superstore. So he's best entrepreneur, American businessman and entrepreneur, best known for founding the retailer Walmart and the Sam's Club. Walmart Stores Incorporated grew to be the world's largest corporation by revenue as well as the biggest private employer in the world for the period of time, like that. So, and right now you can see in the world's rich list is sons and daughters, right? They're the world's about the top 20, they're there because of this Walmart business, right? So currently they have more than 2.3 million number of employees, and right, their revenue, $559 billion, right? Half a trillion. Revenue, you can see this is in 2021, right? $559 billion, which is like a right half a trillion. Operating income is 22,000, 22.55 billion US dollars. You can see operating income, and the net income 13 billion, and then total assets 252 billion, and then total equity 87 billion, right? So Walton family, that's why it's Walmart came, like a number of employees, everything. So they have more than the business. You can see they are business organization, American multinational retail corporation, chain of hypermarkets, and by introduced by Sam Walton in 2021, right? July, Walmart has 10,524 stores, right? And clubs in 24 countries, guys. You can see here, 24 countries, and operating under 48 different names. Not always Walmart, sometimes 40 different names. Sometimes, because when you go to right, you know, India, it's different. You can see because countries name-wise, sometimes they go ethnocentric approach. They're sometimes changing the different name. If you go to China, if you go to Japan, sometimes they might operating under different name. So anyway, so this is a very good evidence you can find. This is a multinational company because they operate in 24 countries in the world. And how many stores? 10,524 supermarkets. 10,000 supermarket. Imagine the revenue. Half a trillion supermarket, right? Revenue. And also, the Walmart's name, the company operates under the Walmart under the United States and Canada at Walmart. As Walmart, this one, the US and Canada are using same name. And other countries they're using. In India, they call Flipkart. Flipkart wholesales. Again, same thing as Walmart, but in India, they call it Flipkart. And in India, Chile, Canada, South Africa since August 2018. So like that. So different. That's why there are different strategies to operate in different companies. The 10,000 supermarket, 10,500 and they are listed in the New York Stock Exchange, NYSE, New York Stock Exchange, and they are listed public limited company in the New York Stock Exchange in USA. Right, like that. So this is how the multinational companies are developing. So in the world, 10 biggest largest multinationals. So you can see according to revenue wise, according to Wikipedia, we can see number one, largest organizations, Walmart, one of the biggest multinational chain in the world. Right? Like that. Okay. We'll see what are the main features of multinational companies. Actually, I have given my handout. You can see the biggest multinational companies in the world. You can see this logo, everything belongs to multinational companies. Microsoft, Nokia, you can see Oracle, IBM, Dell, right? Right. And also you can see Coca-Cola, Hyundai, Ford, right? Tata Motors, right? Volvo, everything comes under, everything are operating more than two countries. Therefore, everything comes under multinational companies. So multinational organization is a company which has its headquarters in one country, but has assembly or production facilities in other countries. So headquarters in one country called parent company, parent country or headquarters. And then it has assembly in production facilities in other countries, like Coca-Cola, Nike, Apple are example of multinational. So features of multinationals, normally there are four features of multinational. So mainly the features of multinationals, me you can see is operate more than two countries, and mainly organization have high financial superiority. They have huge financial backup, and that, so we'll see what are the main features of the multinational companies. So main idea, you can see we go to textbook, you can see the main features of multinational companies are listed here. Main organization, this is as a multinational company, they actually, that's why the main, you can see the main four features. Why multinational companies developed, right? They have first advantage is mainly economies of scale, right? They have economies of scale is there. Many organizations they have operating, because when you want to be at bigger and bigger, expanding might be a very good financial objective. They want to expand and then only they can have profit maximized. So economies of scale is one reason why multinational company develop, because they have commodities, large number of organizations, large numbers of supermarket, 10,500 supermarket. Imagine the, how much orders they have to do, how much vegetables they can sell, how much foods they can sell, how much, you know, consumer goods they can sell. And this is because they can exploit economies of scale, right? And second one, marketing advantage. The global marketing, they can get the global marketing advantages by operating, like you can see the businesses like Starbucks, McDonald's are good examples for this. Actually, this organizations comes under franchise model, like when they were expanding, but this also kind of a multinational examples, because they can globally, they can operate under one brand, right? And then they can actually successfully exploit their market. They can successfully expand their business. They can advertise everything everywhere, because like product like Coca-Cola. So same taste in every country, right? Same state, same bottle, same sizes, right? Same flavor, same formula. So like it's easy for them to market, and their brand will be protected by the patents, right? Heavy advertising, innovative marketing, attract customer globally. Right. So, and also technical and financial superiority. You can actually break down to two parts, technical superiority and financial superiority. So here you can write down those four features there. What are the main, why multinationals created? You can see because of the economies of scale. Number two, because of the marketing benefits. Number two, technical benefits and financial benefits. These are the main features of multinationals. Economies of scale, one reason. Technical superiority, financial superiority, marketing superiority. Like these are the main features why multinationals are created, right? So this is, now we are going to the next topic, the benefits to a country from a multinational company. So multinational company, again, I like to show it in my whiteboard, why, how multinational company operating. I'm always using this example when it comes to multinational companies, right? So if you take a multinational company, like you can see, like multinational company, this is the headquarters. Imagine this is like a headquarters. You see, this is the headquarters, and then we can actually they have different right here, different arms they have. For example, like Walmart, they have 127 different countries they're operating, three, right? And then other, like that, we can see different countries they're operating. And Right. So it's a good example. Right. So now we can see here, now everything here, like looks like an octopus, right? So what I want to show you here, they have, this is like a profit center. These are like profit center. You can see multinational headquarters, and then they're operating in different countries called like locations. Countries are, they're operating, and then they're operating in the country, and they're taking the profit back to the their parent country, which is operating. As most of the multinational companies are operated in the, you can see biggest multinationals are US companies. That's why always we say economy wise, US, China are great, largest economies in the world. Why? Because they have so many, their business operations are there happening in other countries. Like that, you can see if this is the multinational company, let's say this is a Nestle company. Nestle, right, the PLC. Nestle company, they're operating in different companies. I think they're operating more than 190 countries in the world. So you can see here, let's say this is Sri Lanka. We have Sri Lanka, we have Nestle Sri Lanka, and this is Nestle India, right? India, and then here we can see Nestle operating in New Zealand, right? And Nestle operating in the, say, Japan. Right, Nestle operating in the USA. Right, Nestle operates in the UK. Nestle operates in, let's say, Germany. And Nestle operates in, let's say, Italy or France. So Nestle PLC, where is location, is based on Swiss company, Switzerland. Swiss based business, Switzerland is the main headquarters. You can see their business operations. I took only few countries because it's octopus. Normally they have eight tentacles are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's why using only it. But you know, practically they have business arms worldwide. They have more than 100, as I told you, they're operating all world, Nestle. This is how multinational company operates. And what they do, they operate their business, they start their manufacturing production locations. For example, Sri Lanka, they have about 3-4 factories are there in Sri Lanka, different towns. And they employ, they're giving employment opportunities for our people. So that's one advantage. They're giving employment opportunities, job opportunities to our people. And then they operated, and they actually, every year, what happened, they sell their products, you know. What are the Nestle products? You know, the Maggi noodles, Nescafe, Nestle product, Nestem Junior, Nestem Malt. Everything are their product, more than I think the 400 brands they are selling, world's best brands, right? Starting with the Nescafe, Nespre, Nestem Malt, Nestem Junior, so many things, Maggi noodles. So every country they're using, and then what happened, the profit will go back to the parent company. That's what happened. So as a result, they give the production, give their manufacturing, they are giving the production plants, right, the employment opportunity they are giving to the country, and then we consume, and we are using that, and at the end the profit, what happened, profit will go back to the Switzerland. Back, it's called the repatriation. So the profit goes back to the country, we call it repatriation. The word you must be familiar, repatriation, where the multinational company taking money from the host country. So this is the, can see the host, right? This is the host country, host. And this is the headquarters, right? So, and this one, that's why the normally multinational company headquarters located in the, normally sometimes I take in the only Swiss company, Swiss based business. So then from everywhere in the world, they earn profit, they taken back to the Switzerland. USA also same, Amazon also same, Facebook also same, Coca-Cola also same, that's US based companies. It goes back to USA. We call repatriation of profit. Repatriation of the profitability. This is how multinational companies are operating. So that one I'll show you by using an example. You can see now, if you go to the Sri Lankan one, Colombo Stock Exchange, you can find out these multinational companies. Here we go. This is Sri Lanka, the Colombo Stock Exchange, how our public listed companies are here. If you search Nestle, right, the Nestle company, Nestle Lanka PLC is there. Right, Nestle Sri Lanka PLC is a multinational company operating in Sri Lanka. Right now, share market is not so far not traded, but share price closes at 1260. If you go to their financials, right, we can find out their annual report, quarterly report. So just go to their latest annual report, 2020. You can see how this is one of the multinational company and Sri Lankan version. This is a Sri Lankan version of the Nestle, which is a Swiss-based company. Look at the way Nestle, their main vision, good food, good life. And look at the annual report heading, My Nestle, My Sri Lanka. Right? If you're operating in India, they say My Nestle, My India. So this is Sri Lankan version, Sri Lankan chapter of the Nestle annual report 2020. You can see the Milo, the product name Milo. They are giving the Sri Lankans against Sri Lankan football team of the school's football team is there. And you can see Nestle, you can see Nestle Malt. Nestle Malt is there, the product portfolio, right? And they are mainly their vision statement, everything saying that our promise is to good food, good life. Doing the good food in Sri Lanka have been the heart of our business for 115 years. They're operating 115 years. Right? Imagine how long. That's why multinational company, they are actually, this is a new way of operating. Every country, they operate in their chapters and they more than centuries like that. And they are taking the profit out of our country. And also as a locals also, we enjoy their products. And we enjoy their products, which improve our living standard of living, everything. With good food and beverage from early childhood to old age. Supported them from beyond the product to live a better life. Our commitment is to do and make a positive impact on the health and well-being of the local community. So you can see this is the annual report, the Maggi noodles, right? We are eating. Huh? So what I want to show you, some important thing. You can see the annual report, the chairman's message, managing director review, right? Board of directors, right? So we'll go this thing and the management team and the statement of financial position, income statement. Everything is there. So first of all, let's go to the chairman's report and see their business organizations. They can see Maggi noodles and their awards and then benefit. This is the chairman. This is not the Switzerland chairman. You can see this is Sri Lankan chapter, country head of Sri Lanka. Mr. Suresh, chairman, is the Sri Lankan chapter country head. If you go to India, there's another person. If you go to UK, there's another country head. There's a Sri Lankan person, you can see. And then top managing director. The managing director is a foreigner. You can see Fabrice Cavallin, managing director of the company. That's why even the locally operated, they are head positions of the organization, especially managing director and all positions are, they have foreign participation, foreign holding is there. So you can see that's how business sometimes has a disadvantage why the top positions of the organizations are not goes to the local people, right? They're not giving the opportunities for local people because they are head positions are normally goes to their own people. You can see the other one, the managing director review in all three languages, right? Sinhala, Tamil, and English. And then you can see their board of directors. There are Sri Lankans in the board of directors, like that, every country because it's Sri Lankan chapter. We must have Sri Lankans and some of the foreigners also. We can see foreign people and the managing people and Sri Lankans are there, right? Diane Gomez, Kirti is a legal director. So how this company manage the board of directors and their qualifications, you can see, found from Sri Lanka. And the other management team, that's where we can find most of the Sri Lankans are there. And the managing director headed by foreign director and then Mr. Guchen Grover, investment, financial control, technical side, Mr. Thomas Muller is another foreign, and Ms. Sales Division, Sales, Mr. Jagat, and you can see supply chain management, human resource management, corporate regulatory thing, communications, customer consumer insight, and legal. Like that, you can see how they're giving the local people the positions in the organization because it's Sri Lankan chapter managed by this local team, right? So even though it's like an international company, multinational company, but every country, they're actually making a team of managers from the local country, qualified people to run the business locally. And look at their business division, head of food and coffee, head of dairy products, head of Milo, head of Nestle Nutrition, head of Nestle Professional, like that. So they are giving different heads are there in order to run the business organization for the, they have given local people like that. This is their labs and everything, how they're checking this, the quality of the products. Situated as production, manufacturing, everything happened inside the Sri Lanka. some item ingredients they are importing from other countries, and they are giving like everything, like you know, corporate governance, everything. So, but I want to show you their financials. This is start with the independent auditor's report, and then you can see their annual report, right? Look at the profit they have earned. So during 2020, right, and 2020 to 19, they have earned, look at the bottom line, total comprehensive income and net of tax after paying tax is 2.8 billion. This is billions, value in thousands. So it's 2.5 billion, 2.8 billion profit improved. Right. So every where this profit goes to, some of you might be asking, sir, where this profit goes to there? Right? Because it's a multinational company, where the profit goes. So you can see the statement of financial position, SOFP. Look at the statement of changes in equity. The profit goes to retained earnings, right? Their profit. Yeah? Last year they have 5 billion retained savings, and this year they add their profit. Profit for the year, 2.5 billion they have added. And look at the way, and they are paying interim dividend 2.6 billion they taken out of the country. Why? The shareholding, this is actually 90% of the business owned by the Swiss company. The profit they earned from the Sri Lanka, this is about like a $15 million. $15 million they have taken out from the country by paying dividend. What are the dividends? Dividends are the profit share by the PLC companies. They have to pay dividend to their shareholders. So as a result, you can see 2.6 billion dividend payment is there and the dividend payout, right? So that's it. So everything they have taken out is called the repatriation of the profit. I'll show you their 20, you know, like largest shareholders in the business organization, right? Look at the shareholder information. Right. Here you can see Nestle SA, it's a Switzerland company, 90%, right? But I want to show you here, this is a percentage of share ownership, right? 90% of the business owned by, 90.82% owned by the Nestle Switzerland company, right? This is called PLC normally in UK and Sri Lanka, but SA is Switzerland, they call this SA, similar to PLC. So this is 90% of the business owned by them. So 90% of the business that in a profit, actually earn from the profit, they are taking back from the country, called repatriation as a dividend distribution. Whole profit they earn, you can see the dividend payout, 100% dividend payout is there. And because of the regulatory thing, remaining 9%, you have to give it to the public float, like that other people, Deutsche Bank and other employee provident fund and the other different stakeholders. They purchase different companies, you can see. Different private investors also there, minority holding, but majority, 90% of the business owned by the foreign Switzerland company, multinational company. That's how it's operate. It's a technical part of the business operations. Like, as I told you, the business, they operate in the countries, and then those profits they have taken back to the their multinational headquarters, the host countries, the profit earned in the host country, the guest country, they're taking back to the headquarters. So that is called the repatriation. Okay, my main benefits of being a multinational, you should very, very important to know. What are the main benefits of being a multinational company? Now you know that so Sri Lanka is like a profit center. So here from multinational company in the Nestle case study I have not discussed, they earn about $15 million, right? Which is Sri Lankan rupees 2.6 billion, which is similar to $15 million, right? So every country is a profit center. So you can see from here, 15 million. From India, you can see it's like sometime 1 billion. New Zealand, another some millions like that. So all the profit earned from more than 170-180 countries, they're sending back to Switzerland. So this is called the repatriation. So this is every country is like a profit center. They operated there, they make the factory here, buying some premises, employing some people, take the management of those countries, and then they produce and sell and then earn profit, the bottom line, after paying taxes to the government. They send the majority of the profit where? The system. They're not keeping that as why. So it's a business strategy why they are doing business. Imagine the $15 million coming. Look at the business system, right? So they still, that's why they can actually operate all over the world, and like that they can. Sri Lanka is a small, you know, island nation. You can see here only small business operations. 15 million is a small amount. But in big countries like India, China, US, you can see the amount of money they earn is actually huge. If you go Nestle Global, their profitability might be trillions. So you can see that's the thing. So that's how business, that's why the main benefit of being a multinational company, you can improve your market, you can increase your market share, you can increase more profit. So you can larger customer base is possible definitely by operating as a multinational company. Right. Okay, right now we discuss about the, from today's session, mainly what are the main features of multinational. We talk about what is a multinational. We talk about how Nestle company operates as a multinational company. We talk about main four features in multinational, why, how multinational develop, like because of economies of scale and marketing, technical superiority and financial superiority. So these three reasons. And also we talk about a little bit benefit of the multinational, being a company of multinational, you can large customer base you can have. You can lower your cost and you can have a higher public profile, higher public profile. So in my next class, I'm going to, next session, I'm going to talk to you more about the multinational, good and bad to a host country, benefits to economy from a multinational company, and good and bad, good side and the bad. So there are so many examples out there, country actually, what are the goodness, like employment opportunities is a good sign, and as well as there are environmental pollution, some, you know, there are some certain expectation of a profit repatriation. So these are the main drawbacks. We discuss further with the examples in my next session. So thank you very much. See you in my next session. Thank you very much, guys. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.